Hello everyone. I want to give you an introduction how PLM change management is handled in SAP S/4HANA. The following apps and functionalities are available in S/4HANA on-premise, starting with release 2020 FPS1, as well as in Cloud Edition, starting with S/4HANA Cloud Edition 2111. In this video, I want to give you an overview of the capabilities to enhance the UI of our change management Fiori applications. I will first show some slides and then jump into the system for a live demo. Please note that we have used the latest S/4HANA on-premise system, which is currently shipped to our customers. It has the state of S/4HANA 2021 FPS0. Before you want to start using the Fiori extensibility capabilities, you need to make sure to have all prerequisites available. For example, a special role assignment needs to be in place. To provide you more detailed information, you will find a link in the description of this video, which will offer all necessary prerequisites. One UI enhancement capability is to adjust the engineering cockpit. You can create new dashboards, including data and statistics you need to have. For sure, an editing of existing dashboards is also possible. Via drag and drop, you can move dashboards in the cockpit as well as easily resize them. The next point is the creation of app variants. This will be helpful in case you want to access the change record with preset filters. In Fiori, you have this option in almost every application available. A special role assignment is not necessary in this case. With Fiori FlexUI, also an adjustment of fields in the change record is possible. With that, you can add, adjust, or remove standard fields in the change record area, as well as on the change record item levels. Change record header and change item can be also enhanced with custom specific fields. Let's now jump into the system to have a closer look into the Fiori FlexUI capabilities. First of all, I will show you how the engineering cockpit can be enhanced. Therefore, we are accessing the app of the engineering cockpit. Here you see that you have these different dashboard cards available. Via drag and drop, you can easily adjust these single cards. You can also resize them to larger or smaller cards. If you want to edit existing cards or add new dashboard cards, you need to have the prerequisites available, what I just have showed in the PowerPoint slide. You will find more information in our SAP Help Portal. Here you see that I already have the necessary rules available because I have the field of the Adapt UI available on my user. Going into this UI adaption mode, you see that right-clicking on single cards, you have the possibility to hide them, edit them, copy them, or do some other actions. In our case, we now, for example, want to completely add a new KPI card into our dashboard. When creating a new card, we have, first of all, the possibility to add a card title. We can also change the card subtitle. And then we can choose out of all the different metadata information we have available in our system. In our case, we are selecting here the sales order fulfillment and then see that in this case, some data is showing on our dashboard. We're saving our new dashboard and then have it available on our screen. What we also can do is editing or copying existing cards. In our example, we are editing the existing cards. We can here change our descriptions. We can change the filters. We can change the views. And we can also change the type of chart. We can add additional views. Due to the fact that we have no change records in the execution progress available, you see here no data. But I think the logic in this case is clear to you. What we also can do for sure, we can add here the chart tiles. We could also here enhance the quick links. We can copy already existing cards and reuse them. And by publishing, by clicking the publish button, we could select the transport request to also transport them from, for example, a quality to a productive system. Via saving then, you will then see that we have our newly created dashboards available on our engineering cockpit. As next, I want to introduce you into creation of app variants in Fiori. Therefore, we are accessing our app of the managed change records. An app variant is kind of an access to an app with predefined filters. So, for example, if you only want to see the change records with, for example, record status E0, we are selecting this filter on the tab level, and then by accessing this share button in the upper right corner, you see here the button save as tile. We have here the possibility to create our own app variant with the predefined filters. We can give it our own tile. We can also add a subtile. We could add an additional description. We can here select the Fiori homepage where we want to add this tile. Clicking OK. And then going back to our Fiori home screen, we see here our app variant with the predefined filters. By accessing them, we then see here that the filter is automatically set and we see all change records with these assigned filters. As next, we also have the possibilities of the FlexUI on our change records available. So by accessing a change record, we can also switch here into the mode of the Fiori FlexUI by selecting the button Adapt UI. Once we are in the FlexUI mode, by right-clicking on single fields, you see here that we have the possibility to rename existing fields. We can add new fields, we can remove also existing ones, or cut and paste them into different sections. If you want to resort the fields, you can also easily do this via drag and drop. You can change the description. You can add additional fields, like for example, the created on in this header area. You can then, for example, remove the created on the general information section. You can change complete sections. For example, if you want to have the attachments really on the top, you can drag and drop them to the really top, and so on and so on. So as you see, you have a lot of different possibilities available to adjust the Fiori UI to your personal business needs. For sure, it's also possible to add custom fields. So by clicking Add Field, you have here the button of the Create Custom Field available. So here you can create your own custom fields. You can select a type, for example, a single text, a length. You can publish it. In the second tab, you also have the possibility to recreate a custom logic field. And then coming back to our change record, you see that our new custom field example is available and ready to add to our change record. This UI field adaption can not only be happened on a change record header, It could be also happen on change item level. So if we're adding a new change item and going into the details screen, you see also that these fields here can be similar to the header area, renamed, added, and removed. For sure, also these sections like the attachments on the item level can be removed or renamed or replaced to another area. Once finishing our FlexUI adaptations, we can again publish them to other systems by selecting a transport reset. We can reset them, we can manage the app variants, and we can also save it as a new app variant here, and also easily save and exit it. And then you see once we are left our FlexUI mode, we have our new changes available and can, for example, fulfill our new custom field. Thank you, everyone. You should now get a first overview what different kind of UI enhancements we have available in our change management applications. You should now know how the engineering cockpit can be enhanced, how a creation of app variants is working, as well as UI enhancements with the help of Fiori FlexUI are fulfilled on our change record application.